Welcome again. Right now we're at 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 1 through 5. God reveals your secrets. Paul writes, "So let a man think of us as Christ's servants and stewards of God's mysteries. Here, moreover, it is required of stewards that they are found faithful. But with me it is a very small thing that I should be judged by you or by man's judgment. Yes, I don't judge my own self." And this is another example how someone can take something out of context. And you know, Christians are just so known for doing this, okay? See, Paul here says, "I don't judge myself." But yet, in this same letter, 1 Corinthians, he writes in chapter 11, he says, we ought to judge ourselves, because if we judge ourselves, God won't judge us. So when Paul said, "I don't even judge myself," you gotta look at it in context. What specific context is he talking about here? Is it to be applied universally, you know, absolutely to all things? The answer is absolutely not. Verse 4, "For I know nothing against myself, yet I am not justified by this, but he who judges me is the Lord. Therefore, judge nothing before the time until the Lord comes." Again, Paul says here, don't judge anything before the time. Does that mean that we should not judge anything at all? Again, is this an absolute universal application here? Absolutely not. Jesus judged things a lot. He commanded his apostles to judge things a lot. For example, Jesus commanded us to beware of wolves in sheep's clothing. How can you obey Jesus if you never judge anybody as being a wolf in sheep's clothing? Jesus said, beware of false prophets. How can you obey Jesus in that commandment if you never judge anybody as being a false prophet? And you know, there's lots of other examples here, just way too much to get into. But you get the point, okay? You can't just universally say, well, we're not supposed to judge. Jesus commanded us to judge. And I know some of you would say, well, Jesus said, judge not lest ye be judged. Well, again, in context, Jesus was talking to hypocrites. He wasn't talking to his apostles. He wasn't talking to his disciples. He was talking to hypocrites because he said, listen, you got a plank in your eye, so don't try to get a piece of dust out of someone else's eye when you got a plank in your eye. He was talking to hypocrites, as he did quite a bit. And we know that he regularly talked to hypocrites because he called a lot of people hypocrites. So once again, verse 5, "Therefore judge nothing before the time until the Lord comes, who will both bring to light the hidden things of darkness and reveal the counsels of the hearts." In other words, God will reveal your secrets and even the secret thoughts that you have. "Then each man will get his praise from God." Here's a key word, then. On the day the Lord comes. When the Lord comes, a lot of people will get paid and a lot of people will get paid back, okay? So fear God always, because he is judge. I know it's a popular thing today to say, well, God is love. Well, guess what? God is holy. God is just. God is pure. God is judge. And it also says that God is a consuming fire. Talk to Nadab and Abihu. They were consumed by God's fire because of God's wrath, his anger. He got mad at some people and whew, they turned into ashes, okay? In the next session, we're going to be talking about irony and sarcasm. Don't miss it. Until next time, seek God with all your heart. And if you do, you will find him. Call upon him and he will show you great and mighty things. Love you guys.